Well, we all know that all dogs have superpowers, right?
Well, most of them anyway. I don't even know people.
Hello and welcome back to Bambi Man Audio Reviews, the show where I take a look at movies that not enough people talk about. You know, it's funny. For as much of a Disney fan I am, seeing how I've talked about Inside Out already, and a few other Disney films in my horrible mini-reviews that I posted a few months ago, I haven't really talked about a lot of animated Disney films on this show so far. Though I have talked about some animated films, it seems that Disney films have just slipped my radar. Well, I aim to break this tradition today by taking a look at one of the most underrated Disney films out there that I can think of. That one being the 2008 animated action comedy film simply known as Bolt. And what is the story of Bolt? Well, I'm glad you asked, faithful viewer. The days of canine superstar Bolt, played by John Travolta, are filled with danger and intrigue. Until the cameras stop rolling, of course, but Bolt doesn't know that he's on a TV show. He thinks his amazing powers are real. But when Bolt is accidentally shipped from his Hollywood soundstage to the mean streets of New York, he begins his most amazing adventure ever. Armed only with his delusions and accompanied by a cat named Mittens and a hamster named Rhino, who actually think is just as delusional as Bolt himself. He sets out to find his owner Penny, played by Miley Cyrus. It actually kind of amazes me how underrated this movie is. I mean, sure, it's no animated masterpiece like Toy Story, Finding Nemo, Up, Secret of Nam, or anything like that, but on the whole, I think it actually works very well. The voice actors themselves are actually very, 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 very good actors in this movie. John Travolta is perfect casting for this character with delusions of grandeur. I mean, he's pretty much just playing himself. It's actually kind of works out well. I love awkward pauses, as you can tell. Susie Essman is also really good as the cat Mittens. She has a lot of really great one-liners, and she and John Travolta just work really well off of each other. As does Mark Walton, who plays Rhino. Sure, most people may find him to really overstay his welcome, which I think is a major reason as to why this movie is considered to be as underrated as it is. Because the marketing pretty much placed all the focus on the hamster, which I don't really think it should have done. Miley Cyrus is also really good as Penny, and she actually is kind of understated in this performance, even more so than her performance on Hannah Montana, and I am not going to get into that right now. The music is also really, really fun to listen to. It's action-packed, it's relaxing. It kind of reminds me of the music from Fantasmic at Disney World in a way, and that it sort of has that same sort of feel to it, and that it builds up tension, it relaxes you, it's action-packed, it's soothing, it's not really much of a masterpiece of a score, but it still works really, really well. And I also like the songs they put into the movie, you know, Barking at the Moon, I Thought I Lost You. Those are some pretty catchy tunes that I'm sure you will get stuck in your head. In fact, prior to this movie, I actually didn't know that John Travolta could sing. Until I actually saw Hairspray where he dressed like a woman. But I digress anyway. The animation is really stunning. I actually missed out on the opportunity to see this movie when it came out in 3D back in 2008. But I'm sure it looked really, really good back then as it does now. The animation, even in 2D though, is very popping, and it actually kind of feels like a children's storybook in a way. And that's not necessarily a bad thing, to say the least. It's actually really fast-paced and energetic and also very slow at times when it needs to be, which I think is a really good thing in the medium of animation to have. The storyline is also very, very smart in that it sort of plays with the emotions of what do animals go through when they're on shows or movies like this with hundreds of various people around them screaming at them to do stuff. Well, maybe not screaming, but, you know, it really does delve into the sort of subconscious of, like, really, what do animals think when they're asked to do stuff like this? You know, like, jump off of bridges and break through metal bars and stare with their eyes for a bit while the editor puts in special effects of lasers later. It really makes you think in a way. I also really love, there are some great little tidbits here for anyone like me who's ever had to edit a big video. Like, there's this one scene where the editor is actually, where Bolt basically is running to get his master because he keeps hearing him, her scream, Bolt, help, Bolt, help. And you turn, and he turns the corner, and then it cuts to this editor basically pushing the rewind button and editing that scene down. And that just sort of clicked with me as to how much filmmakers and even video makers like myself put into their work. Really shined a new light for me as to what my life would be like as a future filmmaker and video maker like I am right now. Please help me! Anyway, I digress. Overall, the film, again, while it is no true masterpiece, and it does have quite a few flaws, like I said, the hamster character, and, well, it does manage to have a few of those mopey-dopey moments cheesy moments that I know a lot of people who are big classic Disney lovers would just not like as much as, well, classic Disney. But overall, I think you'll find a lot to like in Bolt that honestly isn't really found that much in Disney movies or even Disney shows of today, or even animated films of today. Still looking at you, Chipmunks. I'm still looking at you, Cars 3. I digress anyway. Well, I'm guessing that is the end of my review. How awkward. Well, wasn't that a good waste of time? Thanks for joining me, guys, for another Bambi Man review. And remember, if it's classic or crap, you see through it, I review it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to go wave camera at a dog some more. Ah, cutie pie. Animal ke pe salapus.
लकने दिया तोहफा खोल के हो गया खुश अपनी बर्बादी का सायरन सुन के भी बेशरम पूछे व्हाट इज दैट दैट दैट
Well, most of them anyway.
You can
Who are you anyway?
What? What was I supposed to do?
Oh, wait.